Hello, welcome to video on my flywheel tests. So, quick disclaimer before I get into everything else. I did pay fully for every single one of the flywheels. Everything I used in this video, I paid fully for. I wasn't given any of it. So, it's supposed to be fair, unbiased, and all that. So the Strife I used, basic mods, 16 gauge wiring, 21 amp micro switch. The cage and motors I'm testing with was a Artifact red cage, and I used Hellcat motors. And I use a 3S 2200 65C graphene LiPo. The reason for the huge battery is because as LiPo batteries decrease in charge, they decrease in voltage, but because it's such a large battery, it'll stay at that approximate 11.1 volts for the longest period of time, so I could test all these flywheels without having to charge it. The reason I use the red cage and Hellcats for the test is because as long as those two are the same for every set of flywheels, it doesn't matter because I'm testing the flywheels against each other, not against anything else. And most people who are using aftermarket flywheels are probably using an aftermarket cage and aftermarket motors anyway. So hopefully, you know, this will show you what the top of the line performance out of a Strife can look like. So the process I used to do this, basically I measured everything that you can measure about these flywheels. I also went ahead and ran a few rounds through each set of flywheels before actually using them in the chronograph test so they could build up that dark dust. I'll talk about how successful that was later, but each one used 2 to 3 magazines, and I basically just did it until I saw that they were well coated. Each set of flywheels, I used 10 Elite Darts, brand new Elite Darts right out of the box, per set of flywheels. So here's test footage. I'm showing you guys these in the order they came out. It's not the order I filmed them in, but this is the order that these wheels came onto the market, as far as I know. If I fucked up the order at some point, let me know. Stock flywheels with an Artifact red cage and Hellcats considerably increased the performance while keeping the stock wheels over, you know, a stock Strife. But anyway, they average as our baseline at 109.5 FPS with a deviation of 3.8. The minimum was 105, the high was 115. So next are the worker wheels. They came in at an average of 130.6 with a high of 135, low of 125, and deviation of 3.2. So that gives them a 21.1 FPS increase over stock wheels. After that, we have the Blaster Parts wheels, which came in at a average of 105.7 with a high of 110 and a low of 84, and a standard deviation of 7.8. These actually decreased compared to the stock flywheels at 3.8 FPS lower than the stock average and a higher deviation. Next, we have the two Artifact wheels. So the Artifact straight grooved, those had an average of 125.3 with a maximum of 128 and a minimum of 111, standard deviation of 5.0. These were a 15.8 FPS average increase over stock, so that's pretty good. The Artifact diagonal grooved, on the other hand, had an average of 114.5 with a high of 124 and a low of 98, standard deviation of 10.9. So their average increase over stock was only 5 FPS. Next are Hooligan flywheels. So these had an average of 127.1 FPS with a high of 132 and a low of 123. The deviation was 3.2, and this gave them an increase of 17.6 FPS over stock. And last but not least, we have containment cruise wheels, who averaged 130.6. Their high was 135, low was 128, with a deviation of 2.0. This gave them a 21.1 FPS increase over stock on average. Okay. Conclusions. So the FPS winner, actually there's two that tied for first. Didn't think this would happen, but you know, containment crews, cyclone flywheels, and the worker ones, standard worker wheels, because now there's more, I'll get into that later, got the same exact FPS rating. So which one is better, which one to buy? That's kind of up to you. There's definitely pros and cons of each. The pros of the worker ones is that they're lighter, so the spin-up time is significantly faster. They're lighter, so the spin-up time is going to be faster. They're also cheaper. You can get them from Monkey Mods for like $10. They ship from further away, but the shipping is still relatively inexpensive. Containment crews are $18 before shipping. The cons is that because the worker wheels have that ribbing in them, they can rip darts, especially if you use them in high crush cages. People have experienced that before, especially if you use aftermarket, darts such as Koosh and Waffle darts. Those heads come off pretty easily, so that can be an issue. Pros of containment crew: they were actually more consistent. So the standard deviation of containment crew's wheels were 2.0. which is the lowest out of anything here. That means that there is a very small range between the lowest number and the highest number. In fact, the low for them was 128 and the high was 135. The low for worker was 125 and the high was 135. So you can still get that same high number, but the lower number will be lower over how many ever shots you fire. So that's definitely a benefit for containment crew. They're also made in the USA, so if you care about stuff like that, they are designed and manufactured right in the US, right in New York. So if you care about stuff like that, containment crew's your guys. Like I said before, the cons are that they are the most expensive flywheels that I tested. They're also the heaviest, so you'll have the highest spin-up time and the highest spin-down time, if that sort of thing matters to you. If you're using 180 motors, it's not going to be that big a difference from worker to containment crew in terms of spin up. You'll have a bit more sag on the spin down time, but that's not necessarily a bad thing, because then since they're already spinning, it'll take them less time to spin back up if you need to like rev again for any reason. So it's really up to you. But yeah, both of them had the highest FPS out of all of them. So either one of those, definitely recommend. The runner-ups, Hooligan and the Artifact Metal Straight Grooved, not the Diagonal Grooved. The Hooligan's only lost by 3.5 FPS average. So that's really close, barely a difference. They're also made in the US, so that's really nice. They're also $3 cheaper than Containment Crews, so you're basically paying $1 extra per FPS gained here between the two of them. They also had a really low deviation. Theirs was only 3.2, which is the second lowest. Actually, that tied with Worker for the second lowest deviation. So they're also really consistent, similarly to Containment Crew. Not as consistent as Containment Crews, but very similar. So Hooligan, definitely not a bad choice. The Artifact Metal Straight Groove. Those only lost to Containment Crew and Worker by 5.3 FPS, but they are also pretty expensive. Just for the flywheels is $15, you know, plus shipping and all that. So they're pretty expensive compared to the other options. However, they do have the best sound out of all of them because they're metal. They produce the like lowest decibel sound. And they are pretty light. They're lighter than both Containment Crews and Hooligans, They're still heavier than blaster parts and stock wheels and worker, but they're still pretty light, so you won't have that issue with spin-up time and spin-down time. So who lost? The real losers here were the Artifact Diagonal Groove. For some reason, they had the highest deviation. They were all over the place. Their lowest was considerably lower than stock wheels. Their highest was pretty high, but it was not consistent whatsoever. Yeah, so I don't know what went wrong there. I might retest them at some point in the future because it seems like a weird outlier that it happened. Maybe I did something wrong when putting them on, or I didn't center them right, something. But for whatever reason, they were just terribly inconsistent. Would not recommend. And blaster parts average was lower than stock wheels. I don't really know why that happened, because they're... So blaster parts inner diameter inside the groove is actually 0.1 millimeter smaller than stock wheels. However, their outer diameter is almost a millimeter higher than stock wheels. So they're basically, their only benefit is that they're curved, but that doesn't seem to have actually helped anything because their FPS numbers are lower. They're also slightly heavier than stock wheels. The only benefit to them over stock is that they're balanced. So they will sound better compared to stock wheels. They just perform worse. So why would you use blaster parts? If you are on a campus like mine that has 100 FPS limits for HVZ, then blaster parts might actually be what you want, because then you can decrease the FPS that you use while still having balanced and quieter flywheels. So yeah, those are all the wheels. Everything that I used will, everything that I used in this video, all the wheels I reviewed, will be linked in the description, so you guys can buy your own. And thank you for watching. Okay, so I'm going to talk about flywheel dust real quick and the coating that the wheels get over use. They all acquired flywheel dust slightly differently. The metal wheels have almost no flywheel dust on them after usage. Hooligans had a really hard time getting dust on them. I put about 3 full mags through them and they barely acquired any flywheel dust. The top one actually got more dust than the bottom one, interestingly enough. I don't know if that matters to anyone, but fun fact. Containment crew gathered dust so quickly, even faster than the stock ones, which also gathered dust relatively quickly. I can't speak for blaster parts wheels because I've had those for a while, and those have had dust on them for a while, so I didn't bother recoating them or anything like that. And worker, because of the ridges in them, didn't acquire any new flywheel dust. So yeah. So looking to the future, there's a ton of wheels I didn't test, mostly because I don't have them, or they literally just came out after I started filming this video. Worker just put out a bunch of new ones, 2 metal ones and 1 high crush set of wheels. And there's also Big Hammer wheels, which are worker clones, but slightly higher crush, which means this will probably be almost identical to the new worker high crush wheels. I will get those eventually and test those. The other wheels I didn't test is Artifact has a completely smooth metal flywheel. I'll probably get that at some point and test it as well. And Artifact had a bunch of plastic or acetate, I believe, flywheels that aren't made anymore, so I can't test those. However, if someone has those lying around and wants to send them to me, I will gladly test them like I did all of these. Speaking of future tests, I plan to run all of these wheels 2 more times through cages, the next one being the Black Steel Props Canted Cage, and then after that will be the Open Flywheel Project High Crush Cage. So look forward to those videos in the future. Other future tests I have planned, I'm going to look at all the different cages that are available. Worker just put out a new one. There's the 3D printed one, or there's multiple different kinds of 3D printed ones, and a few others. So we'll see how they affect FPS and, you know, all the other kinds of differences. I plan to look at all the different aftermarket motors. And eventually, yeah, I plan to look at all the aftermarket motors and see which ones are the best for which applications. And I'm sure there will be other things to test in the future. Accuracy, different darts with flywheels versus springers, that sort of thing. After I'm done checking out everything there is for flywheels, I'll probably move to springers, something like that. So yeah, look forward to videos in the future. If you own any items that you want me to test against all the other aftermarket products, feel free to send those to me, and I will definitely test those, because all of these products end up costing me a good amount of money, and I'm doing these tests for the community, so if the community wants help me, yay, okay. Okay, bye.